Hello and welcome to another Dwolla video. Today we'll be walking through the process of implementing the Dwolla drop-in components into a Next.js application. Here's what we will be building today: a simple UI that has two of the drop-in components, Dwolla Business Verify Customer Creation drop-in, and a Document Upload drop-in. Let's do a quick task overview of what we'll be covering in the video. First of all, we'll create a Next.js project and build a basic scaffolding for the project. Then we will include Dwolla Web.js library into the project. Next, we'll be installing the Dwolla Node SDK. After that, we will implement the client token API call. Then we'll use the business verified customer drop-in. And then finally, we'll use a document upload component, and that concludes the task overview. Let's get started. We start by heading to the Next.js docs and copying over the command for creating a bootstrapped Next.js app. Once the app is created, I'm going to rename it to from Next.js blog to drop-in example. Let's cd into the app and open it up using Visual Studio Code, but feel free to use any IDE of your choice. As you can see, this is a pretty bare-bones app with an index.js file in the Pages folder with some pre-filled React code and the public folder with some icons. Let's go ahead and run this app using the command npm run dev. Let's open it up in the browser. Here's the title and some cards with links that point to the Next.js docs. Let's go back to the index.js file to edit some titles and remove some components that we don't need. We also don't need these cards and links anymore. Instead, we'll create an empty div for where the rest of our code will be going. Here are the default styles in the file, which we'll keep as is in the meantime. Now, if you remember, we had two drop-in components in the app, one for business verified customer and one for document upload. Let's start with the business verified component first. We'll create a components folder for all of our React components. Inside the folder, let's create a file named customer.js. Inside of the file, we'll create a React function component. Let's name it customer. Inside of the return statement, we'll put in a div and give it an h2 that says create a customer, and also add a button for create a customer. Let's go ahead and import our newly created React component into the index.js file. And let's view the changes in the browser. Here you can see our button for creating a customer. For now, let's copy over the styles from index.js into our customer component and remove the styles that we won't be using. All right, now to add some functionality to the button, we'll start by creating a React state hook that will track the button click event. For this, we'll need to import useState from React. We'll name our state variable buttonClicked, and the function to update it will be setButtonClicked. On buttonClick, let's call a function called handleClick, which sets the buttonClick state to true. Now, we could do this inline on the button tag, but we'll be adding more code to this function later. Let's use the buttonClick state to do something and hide the button when it's clicked. We'll create a placeholder div for now that just displays do something if the button has been clicked. Otherwise, it will just display the button. Okay, now let's look at it in the browser. The button click works. Right, now that we are done with the scaffolding of the app, let's go into implementing the business verified customer drop-in. We'll head over to the documentation and follow the step-by-step guide on building with drop-in components. Now, before you begin, if you would like to code along, you will need to have a sandbox account. It's free to use, so go ahead and sign up for one. Now, the first step in the guide is to begin the client-side implementation by including Dwolla Web.js in your app. This is the Dwolla Components library containing all of the drop-in UI components directly available from Dwolla CDN. This is an example of including the script in the head of an HTML file. There are various ways you can load external JavaScript files in React using third-party packages. In order to not add additional dependencies to our lightweight project, we will be using the DOM method in our component. Using React's useEffect hook, we are able to load the script when the component mounts into the DOM and also remove it when it unmounts. Now that we've included the Dwolla Web.js script, let's head over to the docs for the next step, which is installing the Dwolla SDK. Here we're using the Dwolla Node SDK. Let's copy over the installation command into our terminal. Once it's installed, you'll find the package in our dependencies in the package.json file. Now we can configure the Dwolla SDK to start making calls to the API. We will create a Dwolla folder, and inside of that, we'll create a Dwolla functions.js file where we'll paste the configuration code. The app key and secret are your individual client secrets from your sandbox account, so make sure to save it securely in your server. Moving on to the next step in the guide, which is generating a client token to be passed into the configuration of the drop-in. These are unique tokens granularly scoped to perform certain actions within your application. Now, there are two ways you can configure the drop-in components for retrieving client tokens, using either a token URL or token parameter. We will demonstrate both ways in this video, but first, let's use token URL for the business verified customer drop-in. Here we have the token URL endpoint example in an Express app, along with the generate client token body that calls the API endpoint for generating client tokens that accepts a body parameter from the Dwolla Web.js library. We will use the API routes by Next.js to replicate the token URL route. With Next.js API routes, you can create API endpoints as Node.js serverless functions. You can find more information about API routes in the Next.js docs. Here's an example of a basic API endpoint syntax. Let's paste that into our project. Every file under pages/API will be treated as an API endpoint. In this case, I'm naming it token URL. Let's paste that API syntax into the file we just created and hit save. If we were to check the endpoint from our browser, you can see the JSON response from our server, name Jane Doe. All right, now that we have the API endpoint, let's head back to the Dwolla documentation to copy over the code example for the token URL endpoint. We will modify the example code snippet a little by recording the response into a const named response and returning the token response to the client using res.send. Now to construct the generate client token with body function, we'll copy over the function code snippet from the docs into the Dwolla functions.js file in our project. We haven't exported any of the functions yet, so let's do that. In order to be able to use this function, we need to import it in the token URL.js file. We'll also need to make this an asynchronous function by adding the async and await keywords. This will ensure that it waits for the generate client token with body function to execute first and return a value or failure before passing on the token response back to the client side. Back in the Dwolla functions, let's go ahead and add a console log here to print out the contents of the body that's been passed down to the function. Oh, and we'll correct this code here real quick. It should be client, not Dwolla. There we go. All right, let's hop back into the docs and on to the next step. This is just an example of the configuration syntax. The next page explains configuring each option in more detail in this table. We'll copy the example code snippet, go back to our customer component, and paste it into the handle click function, which executes when the create a customer button is clicked. Now, since this is a member of the window object, we will need to access it using window.dwolla.configure. Let's add our own token URL to the config, which can be accessed via /api/token URL. Finally, we'll add the drop-in component and replace the do something text from earlier. Let's give the enclosing tag a class name of drop-in container. Then we'll add some styles to that class in our styles tag down below. The drop-in component takes up the width of the parent, so make sure to give the parent div the desired width. And we have an error. Okay, the configuration looks good. Let's look at the console. Something wrong with the generate client token function. Oh, the import is messed up. There we go. Refresh the browser, create a customer. There we go. Perfect. And there's our success message. If we go to our sandbox account, we can see the newly created customer and its details. The beneficial owner is still required and has a separate drop-in. All right, now, if you remember, we had the console.log statement in our function that generates the client tokens. Let's look at that. As you can see, throughout the lifecycle of the flow component, there were multiple calls made to the function by the drop-in library, each with a different action. All right, here's a quick recap of what we've accomplished so far. The next step is to create a document upload drop-in. For this one, we'll demonstrate how to generate client tokens using a separate function that calls the server-side token URL endpoint that we created earlier, instead of the Dwolla WebJS library calling that endpoint directly. This is recommended if you need to pass any custom headers to your custom server-side endpoint. And we will demo this using the Dwolla document upload drop-in component. Let's head back to our project. In the index.js file where we had that customer React component, we'll add another one for document. And under components, we'll go ahead and create a file for that React component. For the most part, we'll be using the same code as customer. So we'll paste that in here, update the function name, and update the titles and the button text. We'll also replace the Dwolla Business VCR component with a document upload. To find that, let's go to concepts and drop in components. Under supported components, you'll be able to find the document upload component, how to use it. Let's paste that in our project. And, oh, we still have to import it into our index.js file. So let's go ahead and do that. Looking it up in the browser, there's our button. Everything looks good. Back in the Dwolla document upload component, you'll see that it requires a customer ID to be passed in for whom you want to upload the doc. I'll be using the ID of this sandbox customer I created behind the scenes that is in a document status. Now let's edit this configuration so that it uses a token function. Heading back to the docs and finding the example, we'll copy over the entire example code snippet into our document.js file, and we'll update the token URL. And now we'll copy over the configuration for token, and this is how you would pass custom headers back to your function and ultimately back to your server-side endpoint. Let's check it out in the UI. All right, there we have our drop-in component. It lets you select a file. I'm using a sample document, and there we go. If we refresh it in the sandbox, you'll see that the customer is now verified. Back in the project, our console log statement printed out the actions that were sent to the client token's endpoint throughout the document upload flow. And there we have it. We have our customer component using the token URL config and our document component using the token config. And that concludes the walkthrough of implementing Dwolla's drop-in components into a Next.js app. Hope you found it helpful. Make sure to check out the description for some additional resources related to drop-ins. Hope you have a good day. We'll see you again next time.